الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله وأحثكم وإياها على طاعته وأحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته جل وعلا ومعصيته. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا شيء قبله ولا شيء معه ولا شيء مثله ولا إله يعجزه ولا شريك له، قديم بلا ابتداء، دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد. لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأحلام ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت، قيوم لا ينام. وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أنك يا سيدي يا رسول الله قد أديت الأمانة وبلغت الرسالة ونصحت الأمة وكشفت بإذن ربك الغمة وعبدت الله ربك حتى أتاك اليقين. صل اللهم وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. وارض اللهم عن صحابة رسول الله المحسنين المخلصين المتقين ولا سيما الخلفاء الراشدون والأئمة المهديون سيدنا مولانا أبي بكر الصديق وسيدنا عمر بن الخطاب وسيدنا عثمان بن عفان وسيدنا علي بن أبي طالب. وارض اللهم عمن اتبع النبي بإحسان وتمسك بالثقلين إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى says في القرآن: واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة. واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب. واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة. This ayah is one of the ayahs of Surah Al-Anfal. And as you know, Surah Al-Anfal, the atmospheres of Surah Al-Anfal, atmospheres of Badr. Atmospheres of Badr, Ma'at Badr Kubra. So, let me retract a little bit and tell you roughly the meaning of the ayah. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً. The taqwa, it comes in many different meanings. But among it, here, التَّقْوَى means fear or avoid. Fear a fitna or avoid a fitna. Let's say, لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة. That fitna does not happen on those who committed aggressions upon you only. The meaning, rough meaning of the ayah. What is the ayah trying to say? Trying to say avoid a fitna that would hit everybody. Not only those who just committed the bad things or the evil deeds. Everybody. Everybody knows law. Now this, when you hear this, you say, SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just, if I didn't do anything, why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish me? Huh? Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. That means everyone, كل نفس بما كسبت رهينة. Everyone is accountable for what they do. So if I do something bad, why should Badr Dabi, for example, get punished for it? We'll answer this question inshallah coming up. But let's see. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَ. Does not only affect those who committed aggressions. What does fitna mean? The word fitna, what does it really mean in the Arabic language and in the Quranic setting now here? And fitna, according to Imam al-Raghib, actually what it means in the original Arabic language, it means when you take the gold, when you take gold and you put it in the fire. The old ways of checking the gold, if it was good, still nowadays, to check if the gold is good or not, what do? You take the gold and you put it in the fire. You see, this gold is good or no good? Huh? يَوْمَهُمْ فِي النَّارِ يُفْتَنُونَ. That, what is the reason for that? So you can see the origin of this gold. Huh? فَتَنَا. طيب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَهُمْ فِي النَّارِ يُفْتَنُونَ means what? They're put in the fire. Why? That fire is burning them. Those who disbelieve, wa liyaz wa ta'ala. Why? So you can get to the origin of things. It's actually trying to purify them. That's one meaning. One meaning of the word fitna, according to Rabbi Asmani, rahimahullah ta'ala, al-Muqadat. One other meaning. It could mean a dalal. Fitna could mean a dalal, misguidance. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who gave fitna to mu'mineen, what does it mean? Those who misguided the mu'mineen. Second meaning. Third meaning, al-adab. Fitna could mean adab. Huh? For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَا فِي الْفِتْنَةِ سَقَطُوا. They have fallen into the fitna. What does it mean? They have fallen into the torture. عقاب, عذاب. Also, one of the meanings of fitna, now many meanings, I don't want to go too much into the linguistic part of the word, but I just want to give you a little bit, a wide view of what the word means. Also, the word fitna, a test. A test. A fitna could mean a test or an exam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِالْشَرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. We will give you good and bad fitnatan. Why? We're testing you. Testing, you see how you're going to come out of this. We're going to give you good and bad. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us tests through giving us lots of things, lots of money. What do you want? Money? Here you go. Take a lot of money. It's a test, actually. See how you're going to act with this money. Huh? Maybe, other way of test, he doesn't give you any money. Also a test. Now says, how am I going to do? I don't have any money now. These are some of the meanings of the word fitna according to the Arabic language, but let's move on to the general meaning of the fitna, definition. What do we mean by fitna? Scholars say that fitna is the event, is an event, or a something where people are divided. In other words, something happens and people have two different opinions, or they take two different stands. One says yes, one says no. One says good, one says bad. يَفْتَتِنُ بِهَا النَّاسِ فَيَنْتَصِمُونَ حَوْلَهَا. This is basically the meaning. Now let's go back to the ayah and see. This ayah came in Surah Al-Anfal, came in the people of Badr. The Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum. But let's move now down to some examples of how things affect our life right now and nowadays, for example, in daily life. المنافقين في المدينة, for example. المنافقين, those that were منافقين at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Muslims at that time, actually they were a cause for fitna for the Muslims. Why? Because they come and they pray. They act like Muslims, but they are in their heart, they're not Muslims. Some of the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, should we kill them? Somebody came to the Prophet and he said about this Abdullah ibn Abi Salul. He says, Ya Rasulullah, let me kill him. Because this guy is not a kidnapper. And what does it mean? He's kafir, not woman. He's a kafir. He's sending kufr into place of iman. He's making people